Good morning. We start off our session this morning with some trigonometric identities and some already resolved trigonometric integration results, which we will use quite often. So, okay, let's take the rules are that the integral of cosine theta d theta is equal to. We say that dy by dx of sine theta, dy by d theta of sine theta is equal to cosine theta. And therefore, integrating cosine theta d theta is equal to sine theta. Yes. Also, that the integral sine theta d theta, we say that dy by d theta of cosine theta is equal to minus sine theta. If we're integrating minus cosine theta, we will get sine theta. Dy by dx of sine theta is equal to cosine theta. If we integrate cosine theta, we get sine theta. Dy by dx of cosine theta is equal to minus sine theta. If we're integrating minus sine theta, we get cosine theta plus. We'll use these results quite often, so you could already jump down in your memory. The integral of sec squared theta d theta will be equal now to tan theta. The opposite is true, that dy by d theta of tan theta is equal to sec squared theta. If integrating sec squared theta d theta equal to tan theta. And the integral of secant theta tan theta d theta is equal to secant theta. Plus, and we say now that dy by d theta of sec theta equals sec theta tan theta. Therefore, the integral of sec theta tan theta d theta is equal to sec theta. Integral of cosec theta cot theta d theta is equal to cosec theta minus. Now let's go into some hyperbolic cosine and sine. So we have the integral of sin, hyperbolic sine, theta, d theta. That will be equal to minus hyperbolic cosine theta. Yes. And that the integral of hyperbolic cosine theta d theta is equal to hyperbolic sine theta. Let's see. Okay, you could also go into the tangent, hyperbolic tangent and cotangent, but we just use these. We could say that hyperbolic tan theta is equal to hyperbolic sine theta over hyperbolic cosine theta. Or we are also using the identities now, that cos A, we call it the summation formula. Cos A plus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. So we are later on, I'm going to show you how we derive that cos A plus B plus cos B, or rather cos of A plus B is equal to cos A plus cos B plus sine A plus sine B. It follows that we'll be using this identity. If A equals B, then cos 2A is equal to cos squared A minus sine So we should have been minus here. Cos A plus B is equal to cos A plus B minus sine A. And also that cos 2A is equal to 2 cos squared A minus 1 equal to 1 minus 2 sine squared A. Now do we get this? We use the trigonometric identity that sine squared A plus cos squared A is equal to 1. So if we use this and we substitute in this one, we get that in this one we get that cos 2A is equal to 2 cos squared A minus 1 equal 1 minus 2 sine squared A. And then cos 2A. We could also substitute the A's for theta. So we say that cos 2 theta is equal to cos squared theta minus sine squared theta equal to 1 minus 2 sine squared theta equal to 2 cos squared theta. Same. Substituting that theta for the A. Alright. So we have the two hyperbolics. Identity the sine and the hyperbolic sine and the hyperbolic cosine. And we also have the common identity cos of A plus B, sine of A plus B. What we do is sine of A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. A equals B, we have the sine of 2A equal to 2 sine A cosine A. This is another identity that we use quite often. Or the sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cosine theta. If A equals B, then alright, are there any other common identity and derivatives, antiderivative that we will need to know at time? Okay. Alright, this will be sufficient for now. And later on we'll prove these from first principles and from trigonometric principles.